grass.
I'm going to go ahead and see what questions we've got. Why do these all look like John Hesham's handwriting?
Hey, Tim, let's definitely get to the auction part, too.
Should we do that? You know what, Yeah, does anyone have any more stuff related to Ben before we kind of go to the other part of this evening?
I was asked at work when I mentioned it, what part of Africa, and just a little more information that was provided on the video, like how do you pick these people, or?
Yeah, so Quebeca focuses specifically in South Africa. There are a lot of like townships, places that are in just extreme poverty, like nothing that we see in the States. And my wife and I did our work over there before our team camp. Fortunately, the team has a camp in Cape Town, South Africa every year, and we get to go and do one of the distributions of bikes in these impoverished areas. So we get to kind of really connect personally with the impact that it makes in the communities. But before, they also kind of shelter us from, or protect us rather, from the really rough neighborhoods. So the places that we've done the distributions have been, they definitely need the bikes, and it makes a huge difference. I mean, the kids that I think that I gave the bike to, he was having to walk like 3 miles to school every day, 3 miles back, and it's not safe. It's really hard when he has a lot of responsibilities around the house as well, to get to school on time, to get back. But that's that's one of the more fortunate people who would receive a bike. In the really rough neighborhoods where they won't take us because it's not even safe for us to go into those places, it's even more impactful, I think. They're providing bicycles to community police, so enforcers in the neighborhoods that try to help control crime. This, I think, to answer your question more specifically, how they select the people who will receive the bicycles, they have people who go into the communities and do the interviews, meet with the people, and select them based on their needs, based on what they can do for the community, and based on their, I guess you could say, character or responsibility. Will they care for the bike? Will they keep it safe? And things like that. And they do, they do follow-ups with the people who receive the bikes. And, so they select them that way. But I'll keep going with my tangent. This second quarter of the year, they've focused on a campaign to try to provide bikes for 1,000 women and girls specifically. So most of these donations that we receive tonight will go to provide bikes for the ladies and the girls. And when we were there on our honeymoon, we're driving through northern South Africa in the bush, and there's literally nothing out there, nothing. And except these little pockets of shanty towns, and mostly just plywood shacks and a tarp and a guy with a bucket advertising his car wash, and people with chickens and cages selling this and that, but and people pushing, we'll be driving through there, and you have one town like that here and one town like that here, and say the school is up here, and you've got young girls carrying their book bags and trying to hitchhike from one to get to their school. South Africa has one of the highest, statistically one of the highest rates of rape per capita. So providing a bike to a girl like that who's walking home from school and to school early in the morning, late at night, it gives them so much more safety. People are intimidated by the bikes and speed, and they're able to just brush past sketchy encounters. You'll see them, now walking miles and trying to hitchhike. You'll see guys pushing wheelbarrows full of who knows what. I mean, we saw a guy with just what looked like firewood or something And I have no idea where he was going with it, because the next town was like 5 miles down the road. And he could have been going that whole way. But it's really incredible. And those are the kind of people that receive the bikes. They're able to increase productivity. They're able to distribute medicine. They're able to get to work and school. It would be like living here and having to walk everywhere you went.
Last question, where do the bikes come from?
The bikes, now actually Mercedes has invested in a factory where they assemble the bikes. And they employ, they try to employ a lot of women, but they employ locals from